I think nine.
That was a banger. Yeah.
I tried.
Try. If that you just tried, I don't want to see your final, when you're not trying.
No, right now I'm on fire. This is the time.
Jai Jai was even on fire. Now it just means, you know, you have bought everything.
Book around, right?
So what got you into music? Why did you, what inspired you to go into music and nothing else?
I do other things.
Right, like what?
I write business plans for companies back home.
Okay. See, we didn't know that side of LAX though.
Yeah,
see, you're making money on one side, you're making money on the other.
We're trying to make money on every side.
So that
we can marry beautiful wife. Huh?
That's what I'm saying.
So right now, girls are looking for money, not love.
So they are looking for money, not love. So you have to make money to find a wife.
So yes, you need
that is not your portion.
Create love.
That's not your portion.
I don't mind.
Accept it, John. Say it's not my portion in Jesus' name. Say it. Thank you. I don't claim for you. But how did you come about music?
Yeah, it was in 2008, I think. Not really sure, you know. I'm old now.
Ladies, if you haven't seen him now, he is not old.
Yeah, I'm handsome. 7 feet tall.
He's even promoting himself. He's a lighty. He's not acceptable.
Light skin with Snapchat filter.
I like that. You know, so many people are actually not as light Snapchat.
And you don't really need beauty or more, so you just use
and filter.
All of that means
editing. Oh, my life is good. God is good. But yeah, sorry to cut you off.
Yeah,
carry
on. So in 2008, after like my high school, I wasn't really doing anything.
Right.
You know, I was just at home waiting for my results. So a couple of my friends used to go to the studio every day. So one time, their car stopped on the road. Then they called me up like, bro, can you take us to the studio? So I took them to the studio. Got to the studio. I just like the vibe of, you know, everybody turning up in the studio. So I used to go every day. Then one day, the producer guy looked at me and was like, bro, really short man, don't you have talent?
So I
went into the booth, did like a little freestyle for like 10 minutes. Then the next day he called me up and was like, bro, man, you need to come and listen to what you just did. It was amazing.
You went in and
so I
went. Are you going to send us that thing though so we can play it?
It's deleted.
Why now? That was your first ginger.
You know, at that time we didn't think that we were going to continue.
I blame you. It's not your fault, Sha. It's not your fault. But how the first time you you saw yourself on TV, how did you feel like your song was out and you're like, yeah.
The first time I saw myself on TV, I don't think I was excited because of the situation.
What was enlightening us?
When I was in school, when they sent me my pocket money, I'll use it to shoot videos. So
that's what you're doing.
At that time now I'm done with school. So I took money together and shot my first video and Jai featuring Ice Cream. So I was in the sitting room with my dad and we're talking and my video came up. So my dad looked at me.
Explain it.
So this is what I said to do in the UK.
You see it? Explain yourself.
So I had to explain to him that, no, you know, this is what I really want to do. I promised to finish school, blah blah blah. And it was cool with it.
So how is it like now? It's like when you guys go to like parties and stuff and then your song comes on, and then what's your dad's reaction?
My dad, the first time I dropped Ginger, my dad called me. He was like, I don't think Ginger is the song that is Joby's song. That Carol is better.
Really?
I have done better. So one night I was sleeping on my phone rang and I picked up, my dad was in the club. He was like, Ginger, that's the song.
When he said, I don't think Ginger is the song. Daddy, thank you.
So he's very supportive, you know.
That's really.
He calls me up sometimes and says, you know, come and play me your songs, your new stuff. So yeah, my dad is cool.
See, I like that because not everybody is as blessed to have, especially if they're in the entertainment industry. Not everybody's parents, especially African, they're like, I want you to be a lawyer. I want to be a doctor.
Yeah.
Entertainment industry is not.